Today I'm gonna show you how to do one of the more tedious processes in setting up a skateboard. This one requires attention to detail. And it does take a handful of times doing this to, you know, really get it down. I guess you could say it is a skill, but this is gripping your board. I'm gonna show you how to grip your board properly. Give it a nice even cut along the edges. Make sure there's no air bubbles. Let's get into it. First, you're gonna obviously need grip tape, which you can get on ccs.com, and a skateboard, which you can also get on ccs.com. Preferably, I would suggest for beginners to get perforated grip. Perforated is when there are little holes poked in the grip so that you don't get air bubbles, or at least eliminate the possibility of getting air bubbles. What that does is just, you know, when you lay the grip flat on the board, since it has this adhesive on the bottom of the grip, it tends to create little pockets of air between the board and the grip tape. And you want to avoid that at all costs, because you can feel those when you're riding your board, and that's really annoying. You want a flat surface. So Mob is known for making perforated grip. I don't know if you can see, you might be able to see the light through the holes, but yeah, they're in there. This is the wrapping that's on the other side of the adhesive. You wanna hold on to this too, don't throw this away. You're gonna lay your grip tape flat on the board, making sure that it's even spread all the way across, and you're gonna start in the middle. Like, so you're gonna wanna start pressing down in the middle of the grip tape, moving your way slowly out to the edges of the board. Your second form, your plan B, your backup security, is holding onto this piece here. So after you get it laid flat on the board, you're gonna lay this sheet on top, not this side that was attached to the adhesive, but the very nice smooth top side that says the brand name of the grip tape on it. And once again, you're gonna start in the middle, and you're gonna press with your hands and just kind of move it all around. Smooth that thing like a pancake. Once you are all set and done with that, you're gonna remove this. So after you get the grip tape laid out on top, you're gonna have a rectangle, and obviously you don't want your board to be a rectangle, and you don't want to have the excess grip just chilling, hanging off. Let me tell you what not to do. Don't just fold it over to the underside, because that's counterproductive. You need a file. You don't exactly need like a file. You can really use anything, like the edge of a screwdriver, your truck. You can use a spare truck or your current truck. Just a piece of metal that's gonna file down the edges, and you can kind of rub it along the whole outside of the board. It makes a very, to me, satisfying noise. To some people, it's nails on a chalkboard. I obviously like it. But then once you do that, you're gonna see this line in the shape of a board all the way around the grip. You're gonna take a razor. Safety first, ask your parents. And you're gonna cut on the underside. Don't cut from the top, because that damages the razor. And it makes it a lot harder to cut. It turns out much more jagged, because you don't have you're not cutting along a smooth surface. So if you do it on the underside, cut along a smooth surface. And obviously, don't cut towards you, okay? That's bad, you know, you could get hurt. Cut from side to side, and you're gonna run it all along the edge of where you filed. Now, if you do this properly and smoothly, and you've filed it down enough, it's gonna be very easy to run that razor right through. After you grip it, you should get your whole piece. It should be all one piece. Like, it shouldn't be multiple pieces. That's what I aim for every time, because that's a smooth grip job. That's what you want. That's what you want to aim for. If that breaks apart, then that leaves a more likely chance of making jagged edges. And that doesn't really honestly do anything. Like, that doesn't affect your skateboard. But to me personally, it's annoying to look down at. After that, what you're gonna do is take your scrap piece of grip tape. Not everyone does this, but I like to do this. Rub it along the edges of the board like sandpaper, because it kind of smooths out and rounds out the loose edges of the grip tape that might be sticking up and could potentially peel off a little bit or tear, leave chunks out. So that's what I like to do. It just kind of seals it. It seals the deal, and it seals the grip tape to the board. Poke your holes too. There we go. Voila, now you have your holes.